here I am embodying the legacy of a phenomenal woman who was ahead of her time. She was pushing policy at a time that would have been very difficult for her. So to be able to live through this legacy and carry that legacy through, to me, is a huge honor. A few years ago, I was working as a nurse in a hospital here in London. And a young man had been brought in, 15, of African background, and he'd been stabbed 5 times to his body. At 2 o'clock in the morning, the same shift, he died. I remember when we went to tell his mother that her son had died, her only son. She screamed, a scream that I'm really, really familiar with, coming from the community that I'm coming from. This led me to the Mary Seacole application and award. Knife crime and gun crime disproportionately affects black, young black children in London. If the closure of a youth club is leading to the death of a child in London, we have questions to ask ourselves. And I've got that confidence and voice to be able to advocate for this very vulnerable group of young people in London. I want every nurse and midwife in the UK to be confident to be able to nurse these vulnerable young people when they come through their care.
My stepfather died from prostate cancer, and he's one of the 1 in 4 black men who died from prostate cancer. There are approximately 1,500 black men in the UK that dies from prostate cancer, and that's every year. The findings is that they were actually saying, one, is that they need a black mentor. They need support. And the third thing they were saying is that when they go to their GP, they don't want to be fobbed off. The purpose of this video is to raise awareness in the black community, particularly for black men, to go to their GP or go get tested. It will make a difference because a number of black men will see this video and think, ah, I need to go to my GP. I need to go and get tested for prostate cancer by, you know, meeting with the chief nursing officer, meeting with key stakeholders, and highlighting my findings to them. I think, you know, I can make a difference. I want to make a difference, and I will make a difference.
If you're on white British, your chance of dying in childbirth or pregnancy stands at 9.8%. And if you're black or Asian, your combined statistics is 55%. Completely unacceptable mortality rates, which are prevalent here in the UK. I'm extremely proud to be the first Mary Seacole Award winner stroke scholar to have won the Queen's Nurse title. And this has been the most humbling experience I've had in my life, to be recognised for the work I'm doing in changing people's lives and in nursing and midwifery care. I've further gone on to be on CNN News, BBC News, Reuters News, and also fortunately been able to go into Parliament and speak in the House of Commons about the work I'm doing, which fortunately has been adopted into the manifesto.
Over the last 14 years, I have been documenting through my research there is suboptimal engagement from South Asian patients, particularly with lower literacy levels, in managing their rheumatoid arthritis. And there is no intervention. How are we going to improve their engagement? And so the aim of this project was to really look, can the Doppler ultrasound scanning sessions mean more for the patient? And can we really optimize those sessions to engage? It's been enlightening to hear patient stories in how actually the ultrasound and imaging and seeing their joints through the scanning actually is helping them to do a lot more. Without this understanding, we wouldn't be able to consider this as a potential intervention. So through this Mary Seacole Award, I was able to develop a collaborative research link with Australia, Professor Peter Wong at the Westmead Hospital, who was the only one who has shown that scanning, ultrasound imaging can help patients engage more. It makes me feel very proud that after 30 years of research around interventions, for the first time, Mary Seacole has allowed me to put together an intervention, potential intervention for South Asian patients, engaging them better. So it's wonderful.
In Birmingham, from where I am, infant mortality is nearly 2.5 times higher in Black, Asian, minority ethnic communities, and some of the highest in Pakistani Muslim communities. And that's a community that I work in. That's a community that I come from. It's been a wonderful journey. I've experienced working with the community that I've come from. They've been welcoming. They've been upfront, they've been vocal, they've spoken. What kept me going was the passion for this community, for the work that I do for my community. And we can't continue the way we are. It's a matter of life and death. The goal is that we need to have equity in health services. We need to have parents' voices heard. And we can't just sit back and keep watching this happen day in, day out. And we need to do something about it. And it was about time. And Mary Seacole Project has really supported me in this.
We felt like a family. This has been the most special, amazing year of my life. I have met incredible people, especially my mentors here on the Mary Seacole Program, who have helped me push myself